This is it. Way to work.
Gem, apart from Goody, who's got the best facial hair in rugby?
Apart from me, you mean? I'm going to go with Ben Foden. Front of the shirt, great voice, very well groomed, very tidy beard, very well shaped hair.
Goody, who's got the worst facial hair?
Oh, it's got to be Jim's mate, Joe Marler. He's got a way better beard than Jim, but it's a bit scraggly, just needs a bit looking after.
Definitely the worst beard.
Well, Joe Marler and anyone else who could do with a bit of grooming help out there, we've got good news for you. We've teamed up with Gillette to offer listeners a range of products with all the precision of a Joe Schmidt analysis session. Just sign up at trygillette.com/rugbypod to get £4 off your Gillette blades at any UK retailer.
Gillette, the best a man can get. Pod, 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 pod. Rugby pod.
Hello and welcome along to this week's Rugby Pod. Thank you very much to Rugby Pass for their help with the pod. You can watch the show live on rugbypass.com together with Jim's new travel show, Rugby Explorer.
Hell yeah!
That was good.
Cheers, Goody. Thanks, mate.
Good.
Thank you.
I haven't seen it yet, but I'm very impressed.
You haven't seen it? Of course you've seen it.
I've seen little highlights of it, but I haven't just sat down and watched it yet.
Just so arrogant. Just
Kiwi, mate. Yeah. You're not in New Zealand. You're not a Kiwi. He doesn't give a fuck, does he?
So you went to Singapore, did you?
Yeah, it was actually a few months ago.
Was it?
Yeah, we did. So first one that we brought out, hashtag Rugby Explorer.
Yeah.
Tell the sweats that.
Yeah, sweat in hell. I embedded myself with the local Singaporean people, went around a few rugby clubs and had a good old crack.
Did you love it?
Mate, it was good.
Hard work, anyway.
Oh, mate, it was grafting.
Yeah.
It was grafting.
Was it actually?
Yeah, mate, show this, mate.
Hey, how'd you sleep in that bed?
How did I sleep?
Yeah,
mate, I didn't.
Your feet hanging over the edge.
I didn't. Tell the sweat that, mate. I checked out there and went to a 5-star hotel, that one with a boat on top. The really posh one, but this showbiz life is not easy.
It's not.
Mate, there are long days.
Yeah.
What do you mean? It's like you don't know.
But I do, mate.
You're sweating like mad. Now you've been in the office
exactly.
All day.
Why
are you sweating so much?
It's 25 degrees outside, Jim.
Mate, this is going to do you good.
Yeah, I feel it a bit.
You go home tonight.
I'm worried about you, though.
Why? I've been in the garden sunbathing all day.
Yeah, well, this is the thing. So I flick on Instagram today. See Jim's. He's in the garden with his missus, and he's tops off.
There's
zero meat on those bones at all. And then he's like, oh, sun's out, gun's out. He tries to tense his guns, nothing. Then his missus does it, and she's even ridiculing you.
Mate, she's decent shirt, to be fair.
Don't know what the fuck she's doing with you.
Mate, it's just the money, mate. She's willing to send me money, mate. But yeah, so I've been in the garden all day, chilling. Gurley's been at work, sweating. Like, seriously, there's going to be a stage where something's going to happen. Like, you're going to go off the rails, like, you're going to faint, you're going to just hit the deck and faint.
For what reason?
Well, you might even die, like, you might even hit the floor. What, like, stress? Are you diabetic?
No.
Are you sure? Fish, what are you laughing at? How do you know you're not diabetic?
Well, I'm not.
Mate, you're shaking, you're sweating. I'm just worried about you.
Don't be worried, mate. Okay. Just don't worry about yourself. You're homeless right now.
Yeah.
In a couple of weeks, you're homeless.
I know.
Like, I'm worried about you and the kids.
Yeah, don't worry, mate. We're good.
Well, they're good because they don't see you very often.
Mate, they are good, mate. They're good. But it's going to get even worse because tonight we've got the live show. So when the podcast comes out tomorrow, which will be Thursday, because we're a little bit later this week.
Yeah, show this lifestyle.
Mate, I've been all over the place.
Yeah, boy, I can do Tuesday, you can do Monday.
Yeah, I was in Cork on Friday, Saturday, did a gig there.
With their showbiz lifestyle, are you finding you're getting recognised a lot more in general?
Ridiculous.
People wanting any photos taken with
like that.
Who's the freak? I get recognised more now, which is weird because it's my voice, than when I actually played rugby and I was killing boys on the bench.
You're welcome. No one knew who the hell we were when you
played. But it is weird now, so I'm on the train.
We get in a partnership together. You're welcome, Jim.
But yeah, weirdly enough, on the train today, and I'm sure he listens to the podcast because there's no other reason he would be taking 10 photos of me, but sat in the chair on the train and this guy opposite me, bigger belly than you, taking pictures of me, weren't he? I know what he was doing though, because like the Snapchat filters and stuff with the bunny ears and stuff. That's what he was doing. I could just feel it. I could just feel the vibe of it.
Was he grab his phone, toss it out of the
window? Nothing, he asked for a photo when he got off the train, mate. I said, you've got 10 photos, mate, job on, chief.
Did you?
Yeah. That's what I said, mate. I should have a minder.
And what did he say?
Mate, you should. Your arms ain't going to do anything. Look at that.
Mate, it's more a reminder of, like, they're just people peppering me.
So, last week's pod, we predicted John Kingston's departure.
Yeah, that's what Jim does, get people the sack. You got Jim Mander the sack, you got Dorian West the sack, now you've got John Kingston the sack. How guilty do you feel?
Mate, not guilty at all, Kingston Town, mate. I think I've done him a favour.
Okay.
Because I was worried about you, but I was more worried about him. But it weren't me who got him the sack. My good mate, influencer, best bud, Joe Marleybone, I think he got him the sack. Apparently he's run up the stairs and he's saying to them, it's him or me. It's him or me.
Really?
Well, mate, that's just what I heard. He's coming on the show, so we can ask him.
Well, we're now joined by Joe Marler. Thank you very much for joining us, Joe.
Hi.
Hello.
Hello, friend.
Hello. See, you got Andy Rowe in the hot seat.
Not been sacked yet, then.
No, not been sacked. Still wearing my glasses.
Trying to get rid of him.
And we've got the Dominator, Jim Hamilton, mate. You know who I am, mate.
Oh, big Jim, how are you, mate?
Yeah, I'm good, mate. Yeah, body's fresh now. Body's fresh. Not too sore. Not too sore from...
What do you mean? From what?
Running over boys back in the glory days, mate, last year.
Oh, mate,
he still goes on about it, mate, it's horrendous.
Look, I've had a little break from all this rugby chat and that, and you're still
fucking
banging on.
Mate, look, do not bag winners, mate. Mate, winners are winners, mate.
Well, I don't know many winners, to be honest with you, mate, but I'm not going to bag you. I'm just going to say, look, just freshen things up.
Mate,
decent guy, you've got some decent chat about you, but...
Thanks, mate.
You keep coming the same fucking thing.
Joe, I like your hair, mate, I do. I like your hair.
The truth of the matter is, I used to live with a lady that works
door is that last door?
I saw it upstairs and I popped up to see it because I haven't seen it for a while and that's it.
Yeah,
oh,
I love that.
But then it's made out to be, he's gone up to abuse to the coaches and stuff like that. I was like,
I don't know.
We don't have
actually no rugby in this room, mate.
Such an arrogant Kiwi,
isn't he?
Ridiculous.
Your humility is just
fucking bollocks. We can't tell you stats, but we can tell you what people's bollocks actually look like, to be fair, and if they're hung like a squirrel or a donkey.
Here's a question then, Jack. In the Quinn's change room, you say you're quite a tight bunch. Who's hung like a donkey? Who's hung like a squirrel? I think that's a fair question.
I can't imagine Kingston Town is, mate, to be fair. Hell of a bum bag.
Who's got the pace in the squad?
To not care what you think of him or the person that's delivering their messages, then it's hard to get any honesty, isn't it?
Yeah.
Like, you look at them, they've been woeful. They had London Irish at the Gloucester game of the weekend.
You expect a reaction.
Yeah,
that was
the more worrying thing.
Yeah.
And this is the thing, so you're talking about those things, and
bastard.
One of the most pertinent things he said, professional sport, players come, players go, coaches come, coaches go, that's the nature of it. You're trying to drive to success. And let's not forget what John Kingston Town has done for Quins. You know, he's been there 17 years, I believe.
Yeah.
So he has been a part of some success. They've won, I believe, the Challenge Cup. They obviously won the Premiership.
Well, they came up in that time as well.
Got promoted. So if he's been there 17 years, he helped them get relegated as well. They promoted. And you talk about Nick Evans and Nick Easter and a comfortable environment. They've moved from playing and being very well respected as very good players into now coaching all the guys that they're playing with and your mates. When you play, you don't get on with everyone 100%, but the bottom line is you try and do everything you can to win each game of the weekend as a bunch of mates. And then some hardcore, when you become a coach, you have to distance yourself from that friendship group because you have to make tough decisions. You have to call people out at meetings. And I don't know whether, take Nick Easter for example, I use my own experience of this. I know Nick, obviously Nick played until he was 37. 36, 37, whatever it was. I also know Nick looked after himself in and around training, so any tough contact sessions, he wasn't doing that.
Because he was fucked.
Yeah. But then, when you haven't done it for 3 or 4 years, and sometimes